The Media Lounge is where it's at. This is the Media Lounge for WDSC WRPT Catalyst Conference Duluth. I'm Kathy Werzer, and we're in this beautiful space with an amazing guy. Zeke Rodriguez-Thomas is with us, Mind Jam Media.
That is me, that is us, that is Mind Jam Media. And it's a pleasure to be at Catalyst, formerly ITV Fest, all over again.
Right, exactly. Producer, writer, and talent.
Yes. Yes, I always tack that on at the end, because it's like, you know, when you come up in the digital space, it's you end up wearing a lot of hats. So more often than not, producer, writer, director is usually the third one, and then we throw on camera talent, hosts,
of course, voiceover. A guy who does it all.
Exactly.
Perfect.
You have to wear a lot of different hats. You got to be super flexible in the digital space, which is where we do most of our work.
So tell me, you're here at Catalyst. What are you looking for? Who are you hoping to meet?
We are always hoping to meet great creators. And what we mean by that, that feels like a really general term, but I'm always looking to meet people that we are potentially going to collaborate with in the future. So whether that is a writer, director, producer, on-camera talent, we're always just looking for great people. It's not always necessarily I'm looking to acquire a specific property. It's rare that that's ever the case.
Because you don't want to start, you know, looking for trends. You don't want to ride a trend and then get nothing, right?
Right. The advice is, you know, especially as a writer, is to try not to follow the trends or chase the trends, as they say. And for us, you know, we have an idea of what the marketplace is, but it also means that we're already a half step behind if we're looking at acquiring something when the trend is already in progress.
Got it.
So, for example, the podcast space is super, super hot right now. Everyone's looking to sort of attach themselves to existing IP. You know, we produce a series of podcasts, a combat sports podcast, a mental health podcast, a top 10 science podcast. And, you know, that's really exciting for us, and we're glad that the rest of the world and the entertainment business is starting to catch up to something that we've been in for a period of time.
Why do you think podcasts are so hot?
I would say that they are so hot because people are looking for a way to be plugged in or like have some form of entertainment that doesn't necessarily require their full attention. Obviously there are podcasts that do, but you know, if I'm reading a script, I might actually have a podcast on, or if I'm giving notes on somebody's project, I might have a podcast on in the background, just because it's a very deeply personal experience. When you have somebody's head in your, you know, somebody's voice in your headphones, in your ears, it's a very personal experience. And, you know, when you meet people who listen to, you know, one of our podcasts, they have a deep connection to whoever the host is. They feel like they might have boundary issues where they're just like, hey, I'm really great to see you. I hear you all the time. And you're like, oh, okay. Like, nice to meet you.
I understand that. Yeah. I understand that.
Yeah.
So at Catalyst, I bet you get a lot of people coming up asking questions. What's the most, give me the top three questions you're normally asked.
What's your project here? That's the first one. And people are always a little surprised that, like, I'm just like, on the exec side this time. You know, we're always creating projects as well internally. So, like, we're definitely feel for creators as far as trying to connect with people. But let's see, top three questions is what's your project? One, two, what are you looking to acquire? I would say third one would be what is the current state of, for me specifically, digital media. And that's like, I'm like, do you have 30 seconds or do you have 2 hours?
Right.
Because I can give you two answers or many in between.
Well, that space is rapidly changing.
Sure. And it's probably changed since we started this interview.
That's absolutely true. Yeah. So, I mean, how do you keep abreast of all that?
You have to have a good Rolodex of people. You know, and for me, I'm already dating myself by using the term Rolodex,
exactly.
And I don't hate it.
But I like that. It's good. It's all right.
Right. But for me, it's really specific about, like, who I go to, who are in my contact list, you know, that I go to on a regular basis. And whether it's people who work in development, who are looking to looking for the next unscripted show, or if they're looking for, it's like, who's the next voice, you know, who's a person of color, who's worked in the steel industry. Do you have anything? And I'm like, not yet, but give me a second. Let me see if I can find somebody, you know. And it's just like having those relationships. I'm always honored to get those sort of calls from development executives because it means that they like and trust my opinion. And based on historical work, I haven't let them down. And it's just nice to be in that space over time and having a list of people that do that.
So I bet this is your first visit to Duluth, Minnesota.
This is. This
and?
Is definitely. I love it. I've only been here 16 hours and already have fallen in love.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's one of those very romantic places. There's a little bit of grit here, which I kind of like that, but there's also just great beauty.
There is, and I noticed that when I looked into the eyes of Lake Superior. Lake Superior, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, perfect. And instantly fell in love. You know, I looked at the construction outside and fell in love with that too, and realized that's some of the grit, so that's part of the charm.
Exactly. Yeah. And when you leave Duluth, what do you hope to take with you?
I hope to leave here with a list, a Rolodex of great creators that I hope to connect with when I go back to LA. Whether it's that, some great IP to follow up on, and then also hopefully some contacts in the production space that should we choose to shoot here in Duluth.
Can you see doing that?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Again, I haven't location scouted very much in the 16 hours, but I've definitely
There's
found
time.
Yeah, exactly. Hopefully I'll come away with some contacts there, because we're always looking for new and interesting settings to base our next script off of.
I hope you enjoy your visit. It was a pleasure having you here in the Media Lounge.
Yes, thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely.
Thank you for the invite.
By the way, you've got a great website. Give the website for folks who want to check it out.
Sure. For the company, mindjammedia.com. And, of course, my personal one, ZekeThomas.com.
Perfect.
Yes.
Zeke Rodriguez-Thomas has been with us. We have much more to come here from the WDSE-WRPT Media Lounge at Catalyst Content Festival. So stick around. We'll be back.
Yeah.
You are amazing.